surprised me this morning. But our topic is on mission.
Yes.
Mission. Yesterday, today, and tomorrow. And this is what I want you to keep in mind. The theme is, are you there yet? You might ask, well, how did you come with are you there yet? When my kids were small and we would take trips, like we would drive to Disneyland, and every hour, they say, Mom, are we there yet? And I'm saying, no, we're not there yet. So we finally made it there. It was a day of rejoicing. But I defined the word mission. And mission is the vocational calling of a religious organization, a Christian one, to go into the world and spread its faith, to spread the good news of the gospel. This is good news. Christian mission is following Christ, Paul, sharing the gospel with the lost world through God's wisdom and strength. You are to connect the world to the church. Connect the world to the church and the church to the world. Now, St. Mark, you can't grow St. Mark sitting in these pews. I mean, you can't grow this church in number by sitting in the pews. You got to move on the outside of the walls of the church. And why? Because that is what Christ obeyed. I mean, he gave us this command. And after his death and after his resurrection, he told the disciples, go. Go. According to the scripture, the local church mission is to proclaim, preserve, and display the gospel. The followers of Jesus were sent people of God, and we believe that he is Lord in all creation. So if you believe he is Lord in all creation, you can't be silent. You cannot be silent. We have to talk about what we believe in. Because see, what I found out, somebody can walk up to you right now and ask you, what do you believe in? And you're going to go, but there's another group of people out there.
Come on now.
There's another group of people out there who walk. And they know what they believe in. And they can get you all twisted up. Amen. Because when it comes to just saying what you believe, I find sometimes it is difficult. But if you are mission-led, you possess the spirits of the fruit. And within yourself, you will find some joy, some love, some peace, kindness, goodness, and it goes on and on. Sharing the gospel, though, you must be humble. You can't be arrogant and walk out of these walls and say, well, you know, this is the way it is. But no, you have to meet people on that level. If you want to grow your church, you got to meet them on that level. You got to meet them where they are. Our mission is ultimately God's work. You are responsible for taking that good news out. You, as I prepare to answer a question, I remember 2019 before I left the church. I was called to ICU because one of my members was going to be taken off of the life support and they wanted me there. So, I mean, I had just a black dress on, just regular street clothes. And I was coming through the doors of the Baton Rouge General. And as I came, I saw a family to the left of me in the waiting rooms, but it was real far down. Now, God sent me there to go to ICU. But when I got to where the people were, they said to me, woman of God, can you pray with us? I'm getting ready to say, oh no, I need to be over here.
God caught me. God caught me. And I had to obey. So I stopped and I prayed with that family. And I asked the question, how do you know I was a woman of God? And they said, we could see the fruits of the Spirit all over you. All over you. And at that point, when I got to ICU, the family was there. The person that was getting ready to transition had not transitioned. Tears were flowing from his eyes. And I took the tear that flowed and placed the cross on the top of his forehead. I said, family, he's ready. He's ready to go be with the Lord. He's ready. And that's where the hope comes in. Christian mission is obeying Christ, is sharing Christ. Now, I saw this on Facebook the other day, and it said, church folks and God folks are not the same. Church folks and God folks are not the same. Church folks go to church. God folks are the church. Okay? Church folks go to church. But when you got God's folks, they go to church. Now this is what I want you to do. I need everybody on your program. On your program. I want you to make a circle. Just make a circle. I know you got a pen or pencil somewhere. Make a circle. And on that circle, I want you to put a dot inside that circle because that is you. Draw that circle on your program and place a dot in the center of the program. And we're going to come back to that dot a little bit later. But what I want to share with you is how when you step out of here, you have God and God has given you what you need in order to spread his good news. Amen. See, God gave a commandment. God did not ask me. He did not say, well, you think you can go and do some mission work today? Could you really go over to that shelter? I need someone to do this, that, and God. God didn't say that in the Gospel of Matthew. God said what? Go. God said you go. That's what he told his disciples. And he's telling us the same thing in the church today. Okay? God will give you the spirit and the sense of knowing when, how, and why. You may say, well, I don't know if I want to go over here. But if you listen to what God has to say, if God says no, you don't need to be over there. Amen? Amen. But Jesus said, if you are led by a mission and to spread the gospel, he said. He said, sir, I'm going to tell you the story here. And it's about a neighbor. You know, the word says you must love your neighbor as you love yourself, okay? You don't have to be close to your neighbor to love your neighbor. Your neighbor may be out here. Your neighbor may be coming out the door here. But God says to love that person. And God says to step out of your comfort zone. Just step out and do mission. Tell that person that God loves them. Give hope to that person. But there is a certain story in the Bible, you know the story, whereby this man was going from Jerusalem to Jericho. And you know what this story is talking about. He's going from Jerusalem. And what happened to this man was, someone beat him. They beat him so bad. Until this man was in a ditch. He was wounded. He was bleeding and he needed help. Well, a priest passed by and a priest looked and he said, I'm going on the other side. I'm on the other side. All right, then a Levite
passed by. Mm-hmm. He saw the man bleeding to death. And when he saw him, he looked. No. He went on the other side. But there was another person, a Samaritan, that came by. And he saw that the man was near death. And what he did, he cleaned him up. He bandaged him up. He anointed him with oil and wine. Not only did he anoint him, but he got him up. Talking mission. He got him up and placed this man across the horse that he, whatever he was using. And he took care of that person. Where are you? Where are you? I'm not through with that dad, but where are you? Think about what would you have done? What would you have done? You see, in that dot that you have, that's you. But on the inside of that dot, that's you coming to church, you coming to Bible study, you going to discipleship classes, you going to every kind of class that got going on here at St. Mark. And you're inside that circle now. But inside that circle, you getting blessed. You getting fat on the word because you just inside that circle, okay? But I want you outside of that circle. Now here is the question. You have a little dot, okay? What I have here is a plant. I have nourished it, I have watered it, I have given it everything that it needs. But when I raise it up out of here, the dot, it's bound. Don't you see the root system can't go nowhere? It can't go anywhere. So if you stay inside that circle, where are you going? Because you see, I've got to take this and put it in a bigger pot. Because you see, I fed it, and it's ready to go out and tell the good news of the gospel. But I got to put it in the bigger pot in order for it to go. And you see, that's where I want your circle. If you have your circle, and if you are staying on the inside of that circle, that is not where God wants you to be. God wants you to step out. He wants you to step out. He wants you to go into the world. He wants you to tell the good news. He wants you to tell the good news. And this song by one of the choirs I listen to a lot, and this is what it says. Mine eyes have seen the glory of the Lord. My eyes have seen the glory of the Lord. Not only have my eyes have seen it, but I'm going to walk and allow God to bless me and bless me and bless me, because the Lord is my help. I will lift up my eyes knowing that the Lord is my help. You didn't get here today without God being your help. You didn't get through the pandemic. You didn't get through the pandemic on your own. You see, God is your help. God is your help in a troubled time. You see, I've been in the valley. I've been there. I've been there several times. But what I do know is that God is my help. God is my help. God moved me from the center of the circle and placed me on the outside of the circle. Church, I'm growing in grace right now. I'm growing in the Lord right now. I'm getting stronger as I grow. Are you there yet? Are you there yet, church? What can you say about your circle? Don't stay and get fat in this circle. Don't stay there. Step out.
It may just be a small deed that you're doing for someone. But God wants you to step out. I'm learning that day by day in my life that certain places I can't stay. I can't stay there. So I'm asking you to obey Christ as you do mission, as you go forward and spread the good news of the gospel. Spread it and bring the church folks into St. Mark. Spread it and bring the church folks to Bible study. That's mission. That's what mission is all about. Within your local churches, you should be able to fly like an eagle. Because let me tell you something. God has you. God has you, church. My help comes from the Lord. Are you there yet? Amen. All of it.